For those who work in and around the political bubble that is Parliament House, a regular topic of conversation in recent weeks has been the former political staffer and now PhD student, Tamara Candy. She's featured on Media Watch and in several articles, always with reference to revealing photos she once put on social media. Ms. Candy has worked for at least two coalition MPs and has just returned from a trip to the US, where other young activists picked up on her campaign and publicity techniques. We spoke to her a little earlier about her unconventional approach to political staffing and to campaigning. Well, Tamara Candy, you are a PhD student who's had a fair share of media reporting about you in recent times, but I want to start with US campaigning because it's often observed that Australian politics lags behind campaign techniques in the US. You've recently been there. What was your role in the US presidential campaign?
Well, basically, I was a campaigner like all of the other young campaigners on the Rand Paul team. My main state that I focused on was Iowa, right before the Iowa caucuses, which, of course, is traditionally big moment in American campaign politics.
And so, your brief was about attracting young voters, was it?
Yes. Well, particularly the Rand Paul team is quite a young team. So within a room, a small room that we were in, there was about 100 students within the room, and those students were relentlessly making calls all day. So Rand Paul made a phenomenal amount of calls to the electorate of Iowa, and I was averaging about 450, 500 calls a day, and I was moving around the electorate. I wasn't in the office that whole time.
And you'd actually started some of this phone outreach before you'd left Australia. There's some new applications and techniques that enable mobile campaigning, is that right?
That's exactly right. They actually use an app that you can download on your smartphone, and anyone can phone bank, or we call it phone banking in campaign terms. It's more like phone canvas, and basically ring the constituents and use the script just like you would within a campaign office here in Australia. But anyone can do it at any time as long as you have the password connection.
Do you see that transferring back into mainstream political campaigning in this election 2016 in Australia?
I have not heard of it at all. I've been on a couple of campaigns here in Australia. I'm hoping to see it here because it has such an availability to reach constituents. We don't focus on phone banking here. We focus on things like hitting the pavement and doing door knocks. But I think quality phone banking that isn't robo-banking, actually ringing this constituent, speaking to them and having volunteers is really important.
And is this something you're talking to the Liberal or National parties about?
I've spoken to a couple. A couple of days ago, I gave advice to a young candidate who is currently campaigning against Bob Katter, and I gave him advice just purely campaign techniques, but he's quite interested in technology and he's interested in looking at this tool.
All right, before we get to some of the reporting about you recently in Australian political circles, I do want to draw back on something that is happening in the US presidential campaign, and that's the use of attractive females to draw in voters and or support. People like Libertarian Girl and Pro-Choice Girl, a highly marketed sort of commodity. Is that influential in the US, and does it cross over in any way with what you've been doing on social media sites in Australia?
I think initially it wasn't my intention at all to tap into that market. I think that's perhaps why I was embraced within the campaigns in the US, the libertarian campaigns, because we're quite...
Because of what you'd put out there on social media, on Instagram, here in Australia, are you saying?
Exactly, yes. The libertarian groups, they're more progressive in that sense. They don't necessarily mind difference. If you go into a campaign office of the Rand Paulers, they might be the hipsters sitting in Newtown. You wouldn't traditionally see them as stereotypical conservatives.
Okay. Well, that does bring us to a discussion about, you know, I use the word notoriety, but certainly your fame on social media, photographs in revealing dresses and bikinis. I think there have been some unflattering terms attached with that, like Kim Kardashian of Kingston, etc. What's your thinking in presenting yourself in that way? Because it is, let's face it, unusual in Australian political staffing or political circles to put yourself out there in that way.
Exactly. I find it interesting. The first call I got about this was from Samantha Maiden from News Limited as soon as I'd arrived back from the States, and I was quite hesitant at first, and I got the nod from one of the MPs that I'd worked for to, I think you better give her a call back. And basically I thought, well, if people are going to speak about me, I'm going to give them my opinion as well. And I don't think that any young woman should feel that she has to fit any specific stereotype to be considered legitimate in any professional field. And the same applies for politics.
So what's the agenda you're driving there? You describe your cause as libertarianism.
Yes.
Before we get to understanding, you know, whether it's a political cause that you're seeking or just, you know, an expression of your own personality.
Right.
What is, just define libertarianism as you see it in the Australian political context?
In the Australian political context, I think the libertarian cause, the liberty cause, is universal. So I think it applies in US and Australia. I think basically it's about limited government. The principle of all libertarians is that they want the government to get out of their lives. So pro privatisation, pro, you know, freedom of markets, and freedom of speech is a huge ideology of the libertarian
movement.
You're
saying that, are you using your image such as it has been projected on social media to advance that, or is it just a happy coincidence that it's drawn attention to your cause?
I do think it's coincidental, because if you look at me well before my involvement in the American campaign for Rand Paul, I was most definitely unique, and I never felt that I had to change in any way. I've never been told that by any of my colleagues here in Parliament. So I think that is coincidental. However, the fact that the Rand Paul libertarian supporters have embraced me, I think you can tie that back to the cause and the other characters within our cause, such as libertarian and pro-life girl that you mentioned.
You're talking there almost in the past tense. Does that mean that earlier projection of your image is now over because you've become, what, more mainstream now? Is that the idea?
No, I'll stay myself. I've been probably less, I've been posting less on social media, and that would be because I'm so busy at the moment. But no,
anyone's told you to tone it down or...
No, I mean, I had comments saying, you know, blonde bimbo and things like that. And other libertarian girls have had similar commentary. I think there was a word bimboization, I think I saw them saying they're, you know, dumbing down the cause, but I think that's a small minority of the libertarian group that thinks that.
Is any of the reaction to you here in Canberra or in Australian media, do you view it as sexist?
I think there's a fine line. When you're looking at the reporting, a lot of the reporting, you couldn't really accuse the journalist of being you know, against my favour.
Right, but the trolls, the internet...
The internet trolls,
pile on.
Most certainly. They have actually quietened down since I've made my case to Mamma Mia and a few other news outlets, because I've had my voice. It's not just an image of me. I've been able to defend myself and to speak articulately about my interest in politics and why I'm doing this.
Okay, and your interest in politics in this election campaign year, what is your status? Are you working with or for any Liberal LNP people, or are you likely to in the campaign?
I'm likely to. At the moment, I'm helping with some pre-selections in ACT. I believe that I will do that. I do believe I'll be going back to the States at some point as well. So Students for Liberty or one of those other Rand Paul associated groups. I have a lot of friends there, and I'm looking forward to going back and seeing them again and doing
All right, what I can. Tamara Candy, one day, I suppose, to be Dr. Candy, for your thoughts today. Thank you.
Thank you.